Okay, you guys, I'm making this short and sweet because this video is long, but trust me, you do not want to skip through it. There were so many things I found while shopping through the aisles of Costco that said they were keto when they actually were not. You're not going to want to miss this. Hi guys, certified nutritionist and keto specialist Samantha Souza here. Today we're going to be going through the aisles of Costco. You're going to come shop with me to find all the keto finds and major misses. Let's get going.
Ah, Costco. We all love it. Let's start off right away with just these shelled pistachios. They're just the Kirkland brand. I normally don't recommend getting pistachios shelled. I think a shelled pistachio is an amazing snack because the ratios and the vitamins that are inherently in these nuts are incredible. But when you have the shell on, it takes a little bit longer to eat them, and therefore you don't eat as many because, as you know, it's very easy to overdo it on nuts. Now, I liked these because I'm thinking about making a pistachio butter. And for $13.99 versus the, you know, full mix, I think that's a better move. Also, you know, not all of these nuts are created equal. I really like pistachios. So if you can pick some up, I would recommend if you're just planning on snacking with them, definitely get the shelled ones. That's going to be better for you health-wise. And it's kind of like an activity and a snack. If you're more of an almonds person, or here we go with my seasoned shelled babies, I mean, I know they're more expensive, and I'm not sure like weight for weight in terms of the actual nut you'd be getting, if it's a deal or not, but I think for lifestyle, it's better. But if you're into nuts, oh my goodness, I love Costco for nuts. Just be aware of these, you know, trail mixes. They're usually sweetened. Dried berries are not the move, even if you can normally have, you know, berries. I wouldn't get them dried. It's way too many carbs. They have literally every single flavor of this premier protein. I know this is super popular in the keto world. Honestly, I'm not really sure why, other than it just doesn't have a lot of inherent carbs in it. Don't get the oat one though. The oat one is crazy town in terms of the carb count. These are fine. I just think that I'd rather get 30 grams of protein from food instead of a shake. Most of my clients, they're eating way too much protein, and they are overdoing it and drinking something like this. While it has a lot of, you know, viable nutrients and things like that, it's all well and good, but nothing's going to be absorbed in your body the same way and as well as real food. So they're here for a decent price if you want them, but they're not my favorite thing, and I would never tell somebody to go get a protein shake. All right, here I found some new Zip Fizz Immune Health. It's $18.99, which is cheaper than the normal Zip Fizz you can find at Costco. I was trying to figure out what is different about this Immune Health one to the other one. And honestly, this one seemed like it had more going for it. It just seemed to have a lot more ingredients, and it has the ashwagandha, the various mushrooms. I think that these things are great for cognitive function, especially in the morning. Plus, you have all of the vitamins, minerals, things that help with electrolytes. And it's still a 30-day supply. So I'll show you the regular Zip Fizz in a second. But to me, this kind of seemed like the move, and it was a lot cheaper. So if you are into taking something like this, I would go for it. Because take a look. This one's $27.99, almost $10 more. You get the exact same amount of servings. And to me, it looks like it has a lot less in it. So the amounts of some of these things are slightly higher than they were in the Immune one, but all the other benefits like the mushrooms, etc., I feel like are going to be way more worth it. Plus, it's cheaper for the same amount of servings. That's my opinion. I'm not personally a Zip Fizz user, but a lot of people like it, so I wanted to bring it up here. Here we have something similar, like an electrolyte drink, but please, please, please avoid this at all costs. The total carbs are crazy, and the first ingredient is cane sugar in both of these. So just be aware when you're looking for an electrolyte drink that it does not have sugar in it. Most of them do, because there's a lot of science out there that says in order for you to metabolize any sort of electrolytes, you need to have them combined with sugar. And as we all know, that's just not inherently how it works. Now we have some organic MCT oil, and it is $18, which I don't know if this is a good deal or not, to be honest. I think I've purchased this on Amazon before, and it was probably around that same price. Honestly, I just don't think MCT oil is really worth it. You can get it from coconut oil in almost the same amounts, and it's a lot less money. I know a few of you are going to be interested in these no sugar keto cups, but I have tried them, you guys. I spit this out. It's not for me. I know certain people like it. It's questionable to me too, ingredients wise, because the first ingredient is chocolate liqueur, and I don't know how I feel about that as an ingredient, especially if it's going to be the thing that is the most in this. So for me, not only does it have a questionable ingredient list, but also it tastes to me like garbage. I much prefer the ones from Quest are unbelievable. And at least I know what everything is in there. So I'd rather have it taste good. That's just me. Now in the world of jerky, this is something that I want to point out as being, you know, the kind of marketing that might seem like, oh, this looks like it's going to be good. No nitrates. It's, you know, no artificial ingredients, but I got news for you. Brown sugar is not an artificial ingredient, but yet it's not something we're looking for, right? So always check the ingredients list on every single jerky. I'm telling you right now, don't look at any of the outside labeling. Now these Kirkland protein bars are also super popular. I think I read somewhere that they changed the recipe on these, so now the macros are even worse than they were before. I never liked these in the first place. They were always kind of an iffy product for me, but now they're even more so because the total carbs are just too high. And I know even if you're a net carb person, you really still have to take into account total carbs. So these for me are gonna be a pass. Here, however, we have some Archer Provisions delightful grass-fed beef sticks. Again, it says zero sugar per stick, but you still always wanna look at the ingredients. What did we learn 5 seconds ago, right? So it looks good, grass-fed beef, no sugar, and then the ingredients list is super clean, no sweeteners, nothing. It's as if you made it at home. And the macros look nice. These look like an amazing purchase. Definitely something to keep in your purse if you're ever looking for a snack. These, however, are the worst, most garbage things ever. Again, don't just look at marketing. 3 grams of sugar does not mean 3 grams of carbs, people. And even if you're doing net carbs, the ingredients list negates any sort of potential here. It's full of maltitol and horrible things, so don't do it. Now, these are my favorite chicharrones or pork rinds on the planet, 4505. The ingredients list is really clean, even though it does have a little bit of, I think, like a curing sugar or something in it, but it's like the last thing on the list. So I don't worry about it, and I rather have something that has this kind of texture and the way that they treat their animals, etc. That to me is more important than literally the tiniest bit of palm sugar. So again, they're also getting fried in their own pork fat, and to me that's more important because what we don't want when we're looking at our chicharrones or pork rinds is something that's been fried in a vegetable oil. So I rather have the teensiest little bit of palm sugar and have it be fried in its own pork fat. You feel me? I'm not a huge fan of wisps personally, especially not the Parmesan ones, but if you're into them and you like them as a chip replacement or something to use with dips, something at the movies, whenever that happens again, you know, that I can see, but this flavor isn't my favorite. They do have another one here at the store though. I was curious about these dehydrated mushrooms. I know that mushrooms have carbs, but I was just intrigued. We have palm oil, maltose, which is like a certain form of sugar. I'm gonna give these a no, even though, you know, you guys probably know that mushrooms are a little bit carby, but sometimes I'm about them, in moderation, of course. Okay, some people are really into seaweed, you know, snacks in terms of a chip replacement. It's always good to see what kind of oil they're using. Sunflower oil, not my favorite. Sesame oil can be beneficial in some cases, but if you're not that sticklery about that, like I am, then go ahead and give these a try. Kale chips, again, I just feel like they taste like you're eating a fart. It's not my jam, but some people like them. These are great. The fat to protein to carb ratio is awesome, and it's fairly clean, and at least the kale is organic, so that's another option here at Costco. I'm just glad that they're taking what we want into account, even if not all of the ingredients are bomb.com. Here, okay, here's an example of tricky marketing. Look, it says baked seaweed crisps with extra crispy brown rice chips. At the very small print, I got news for you. When you look at the ingredients list, this is actually mostly made of rice with a little bit of seaweed. It's so frustrating. They trick you with the marketing. Here we have that other brand of wisps, which I didn't have the no desire to try, but this is definitely more up my alley. Okay, don't even get me started. We're about to go down this aisle full of keto products that are frustrating the hell out of me. This is supposed to be a keto, quote unquote, trail mix. Okay, coconut, dark chocolate. What makes this keto? It says 6 grams of net carbs. Okay, is the chocolate unsweetened? What's the deal here? No, it's exactly like any other trail mix. By the way, the almonds are roasted in canola oil, cottonseed oil. We have dried coconut, doesn't say if it's unsweetened or not. Then we have all sorts of sugar, corn syrup, brown sugar, everything in this. What is the marketing here? What makes this keto? This is literally regular chocolate sweetened coconut trail mix. It's disgusting to me, the marketing that happens here. Then we have coconut keto clusters. Giant words keto. Okay, let's just check and see. 4 grams of net carbs. It looks like we got some ingredients here that would be all right. Okay, well, let's actually see what's in this. Got a lot of nice branding here. Zero trans fats. Okay, cool. Coconut, pumpkin, cane sugar. Oh man, okay, cane sugar, brown rice syrup, which is just another form of sugar, agave fiber. What about this is keto, please? Absolutely nothing. They're hoping that you're stupid and you don't actually look at the ingredients list, or that you just don't know what to look for. Thanks a lot. Feel free to follow the link down below to schedule a free consultation call with me if you are interested in trying to figure out how to do keto to the absolute max benefit, how to manipulate your body composition on demand. If you're somebody who's been stuck doing keto or you feel like you've stalled out, go ahead and book a call. Let's talk about it. We can figure it out. But in my Diet Destroyer program, I do talk about this product specifically. I've talked about it before on the channel. I believe it was in my Keto at Home Goods video. But this one is crazy because the carbohydrates do not even make sense. 3 + 4 = 7, not 6. So how is that even an accurate nutrition label? It has keto all over the place, says keto certified, and yet has cane sugar in the ingredients, and the nutrition label does not even add up properly. This is a garbage dumpster fire product of lies. Ask me how I really feel. Next up, we have some macadamia nuts. These are dry roasted nuts. That means that it's just the nut, nothing else. Oftentimes, you will see other things in your nuts where it should just be themselves, and it's not. If you watched my Keto at Aldi video, those had maltodextrin in them, which is crazy. These are just a dry roasted macadamia nut and sea salt. These are the best nuts for keto. They're perfect ratios, great for snacking. You could also blend these up and make a macadamia nut butter. Dry roasted nuts are the best kinds of nuts. These are organic macadamias that have a garlic and olive oil flavoring and coating on them. The other oil used in the ingredients list you will see is avocado oil, so we're totally all good with that. This is, I guess, if you prefer an organic option or maybe something that has a seasoning or a flavoring to it, if plain macadamias are not your jam. These organic coconut unsulfured and unsweetened coconut chips are unlike any other coconut chip I've ever had. Look at that ingredients list, doesn't get cleaner than that. They are high in natural fiber, but that's totally okay in my book. These are also the thickest coconut chips I've ever had. These are not like those wafer thin, super brittle things. These are thick crisps, you guys. And for $9, they're a great snack and they're pretty hard to overeat. They also have hemp hearts here. Organic at that. I don't know if this is a great buy unless you're making like keto oatmeal all the time. You can find this super cheap, maybe $3 for a smaller bag, of course, at Home Goods. So I don't know how many hemp hearts you need, but it's just nice to know that they are organic and they are here, and the Kirkland brand is always bomb. Next we have Rao's, however you want to say it. It is the preferred low-carb world's pre-bottled marinara sauce. You get 2 for this price because they're attached. Look at how clean and low-carb this is. The ingredients are just literally things that you would put in there if you were making it at home. And it's pretty hard actually to find marinara sauce that has really clean ingredients like this and such a low-carb count. So this is a great purchase if you're not somebody who makes their own sauce at home. Like me, I'm Italian. It would be sacrilege if I didn't. Also, Costco, the Kirkland brand, is literally some of the best almond flour you can buy, and the price is pretty good to boot. It's blanched, it's milled super fine. It says so right there, and it's from California, so hello, you're welcome. We also have Primal Kitchen Buffalo Sauce. It's 10 bucks, so if you're making wings all the time, this is a good investment. It's made with avocado oil, which is really interesting. When I make homemade buffalo sauce, I make it with butter, which is pretty typical. But this is good also if you are vegan. It's nice as it doesn't have butter. It uses avocado oil, so it is more healthful. I love everything Primal Kitchen does. And speaking of Primal Kitchen, they also have their avocado oil mayo for 9 bucks for a jar this big is a great deal. It's really important to pay attention to the oils that are in your foods, guys. I know it's hard to avoid soybean and canola and other vegetable oils, but if you can help it, this is one of the things that will make a huge difference to your heart health. Doing keto outright is going to help. Being really particular about the oils is going to help even more. So this is a great buy. Next, we have some organic and non-organic pecans. I say pecans. This is great because nuts can be so expensive, especially pecans. So for the amount that you're getting, I think it's a worthwhile investment. Whether or not you want to shell out more for the organic or not is really up to you. But this is great for making cheesecake crust, etc. If you haven't made my keto cheesecake, you definitely need to go over there to my Instagram and check that out because that is an amazing recipe. Next, we have avocado oil. This is great. It's such a huge amount for 20 bucks. They also have this, which I thought was fascinating. It's avocado, MCT, and chia oil all in one. It's really important when buying oils, you guys, that you get a dark bottle. It makes the biggest difference. It prevents your oil from going rancid and being carcinogenic, etc. So just make sure that whenever you do buy an oil, you buy it in a dark container. But look at this. This looks pretty interesting. I think this is a fascinating item that would probably go for much, much more. And it's a big, decent-sized bottle, too. So I would be very curious to try this. However, if you want to go for bulk is better, avocado oil, that's going to last you a very long time. Again, if you're buying olive oil, you want to get it in a dark container. Don't do something like this. Obviously, you're not getting grapeseed oil in general, but do you see how it's a light container? That's going to not only give you crazy mad heart issues, but also it's just going to go bad. So just make sure you don't do that. Next, we have pork panko. This is so exciting to see. It's 11 bucks, which if you wanted to just make your own homemade pork panko, it's probably going to be cheaper, but this is very convenient. And look at the ingredients list. Pork rinds, salt. We love that journey for us. I truly, truly love using this as a replacement for panko in general or breadcrumbs, making meatloaf, what have you. I've used this product before. It's amazing. And we also have some organic coconut manna. You know me, I love, love, love me some coconut cream. And this is a very similar way to have it. It's not like coconut oil. It's actually mixed up with the oil and the meat from the coconut. So it's a great heart healthy snack. It's a really great way to get your extra fats in. And normally this would be about the same price for a jar half the size if you bought it at a regular grocery store. So you can just see the ingredients are just organic whole coconut meat and the natural occurring oils. So definitely picking that up. Also, I know this seems really expensive, 24 bucks for this giant thing of ghee, but I'm telling you, the last time I bought one of these, it lasted me an entire year. So it's a good investment, and it's a really, really well-crafted small batch ghee, and I trust this brand implicitly. It's grass-fed butter at that the ghee is coming from, and pastured cows. So trust me, you'll get what you pay for. It feels like a lot in the beginning, but you'll have it all year long. I also spied this avocado oil that's a spray. It's nice if you don't want to have a whole tablespoon of something and you just want to coat a pan, and at least it's a spray and it's avocado oil. So this is much better and more heart healthy than using something like Pam. And again, these will last you forever. I'm spying some of those Birch Benders keto pancakes, but I will tell you, I never saw them anywhere out to get. So I don't know if they're just waiting to open up the palette or what, but I couldn't get my hands on them. I could eventually get my hands on this keto granola. I love this stuff. I've used it in the past. I put it on my Instagram, which if you're not following me, you definitely should. The ingredients are super clean. I'm not saying you should overeat this by any means because the carbohydrates do add up, but at least it's all natural occurring foods and some keto approved sweeteners like erythritol and monk fruit. Super clean, and I really, really enjoy it. Okay, here we have the Nutso 7-Seed Nut Butter. This is pretty pricey, but dang if it's not a really awesome product. Really clean ingredients, no sugar added, a bunch of different nuts, so you get a great different, you know, diverse profile here. And look, all of these nuts are dry roasted, which, as we learned from earlier, is super, super important. If you want to get a really amazing quality nut butter, it's $15, but you get what you pay for. However, I do feel like if you just want to go straight to almond butter, this one's organic and it has no other weird ingredients in it. It's so hard to find nut butters that are not just nuts or maybe just nuts and salt. It's shocking how hard it is to find. So this is a really good price. I personally don't like almond butter, but I know a lot of people do. And if you are allergic to peanuts or you get inflammatory response from peanuts, then that's the way to go. Otherwise, I always, always, always pick up this organic peanut butter from Kirkland. It is literally just peanuts. It tastes amazing. I absolutely love this peanut butter and I don't have an inflammatory response from peanuts. So this is the way that I go. They're dry roasted, sea salt, and that's it. That's why this is my favorite peanut butter of all time. Next, we have some sugar-free sweeteners. We have stevia and monk fruit blend. I believe this also has other things in it. Yep, erythritol. So it's really an erythritol stevia and monk fruit blend. Again, what are natural flavors? I hate when they say that because we never know, but it's not a horrible option. I also like Truvia. The ingredients are basically the same except without the monk fruit. So if you don't like monk fruit or you have a weird aversion to it, then maybe go the Truvia route. I tend to use that more. Don't do Splenda, you guys, but they have Lakanto, which to me is the best, but you're going to pay the most for it. Again, you get what you pay for. We know this, which is why it's helpful to save by buying it at Costco. But look at these ingredients. Erythritol, monk fruit, no natural flavors, no, you know, mysterious other things in it. And if you don't like stevia, then this is probably going to be the best combination of things for you. We all know that Costco is a great place to stock up on dairy, meats, you know, those things that we're buying in bulk, cream cheese, sour cream. This is a great place for that. But what's awesome is that Kirkland has sales on two different kinds of mozzarella. This one, this brand right here, is a whole milk mozzarella as opposed to, you know, a part skim. So I would always go that route if you can help it. They also have these really cool provolone slices that I feel like would be a great substitute for like a taco or something like that if you wanted to use it as a wrap or like in a deli sandwich. They're a good size. They even know it's perfect for a low carb diet. And I think that these are really, really cool if you wanted to use them as sort of like a lettuce wrap replacement. They also have Kerrygold, but it's $13 for 4 bricks, which I feel like I can buy the individual bricks as I go for pretty much the same price at the regular grocery store. So it really just depends on how much you're paying for Kerrygold at home. But I feel like this is basically the same price. $3 a packet, it's pretty standard. Here we go with the giant containers of cream cheese and sour cream. This sour cream was literally only $4. So that to me is like the best buy of the day. I definitely use both of these things all the time. And so I feel like buying them at Costco is super cost effective and it honestly uses a lot less plastic because you're not buying multiples of the smaller containers. Costco also has a myriad of options when it comes to bacon. It's pretty crazy. My best recommendation for you is that Kirkland thick slice bacon is my favorite, but just aim for one that does not have any sort of flavoring or sugar or maple. That is not going to be the best option for you. They also had some paleo sausages available. My personal favorite, honestly, skip this maple bacon. That's not the move. Go to the Kirkland brand. It's super thick. I love that. It seems like you're getting less, but trust me, you will go through it not as quickly because each slab is pretty thick there. They also had these Teton, I don't know the phrasing, but they're 100% grass-fed beef, little like smoky style snack hot dogs. These are awesome. The ingredients are super clean. I've tasted these before and they taste unreal. They're an amazing keto snack if you feel like either snacking on them cold because they are cooked, or if you want to make a little lunch out of it. Also, if you're trying to help your kids be more healthful, these are great for children. I saw this little frozen chicken marsala with rice cauliflower dinner. I'm going to tell you, the ingredients and the carbs on this were just not ideal. It seems like a pretty decent option, maybe if you're in maintenance, but to me, the carbs were just a little bit too high. The ingredients were not horrible, but there was cane sugar in there. To me, I'd rather just make my own option. But again, If you don't have time, something like this could be convenient for you. Again, it's going to be a matter of personal preference if you can make this fit or not. This is one of those famous cauliflower crusts I see everybody talking about. The ingredients are horrible. I don't know what happened to this clip, but when I went to film it, I guess I pressed record and then I accidentally stopped it. But I'm just letting you know, like, the first ingredient is brown rice and a bunch of other things that you can't have. So just avoid. I'm slowing this down so you can see what I'm talking about and you can see the product, but I apologize for this footage, y'all. Instead of buying MCT oil, just buy a giant drum of coconut oil here. They also have a pretty decent looking quality organic chicken bone broth. If that's something you have all the time, it's a good place to stock up on it here at Costco. But also, I just wish I had the money to buy all of this seafood. I'm so seafood obsessed. If you have a big family, this is great. That box of giant king crab legs that were the same size as my forearm was about $225. So I've also tried this keto ice cream before. I really liked the bars. That was actually my favorite iteration of everything that I've tried from this brand. And it's just great to find keto ice cream options at Costco. The ingredients here are pretty clean, like I said, and it's definitely a worthwhile option, and the macros are phenomenal. Next, the reason why I came in the first place, Real Good Foods now has their items in bulk at Costco. This is an amazing product. I've had it before, and it is a bacon wrapped stuffed chicken with various types of cheeses. It's raw, you guys, so you have to cook it like completely. And you get 6 of them for less than $10 here at my Costco. It's amazing. I'm actually running a giveaway with them on my Instagram, so go follow me there. Real Good Foods is partnering with me to actually give away a $50 gift card to Costco. Not even to Real Good Foods, it's a gift card to Costco. So go check out my Instagram, and if the video is still running in time for you to go check it out, it's over in a few days. So if you're one of the first few people watching this video, then you still have time to go enter to get a $50 Costco gift card. They also have duck breast, you guys. This is so exciting. Duck breast is full of delicious fat that you can render from the skin and then save to eat with other things. They also have grass-fed beef patties here. I don't know if they're grass finished or not, but if you're somebody who cares about grass-fed meat, it's nice to have it just ready to go in the freezer if you want. Otherwise, you can save a couple bucks by getting the traditional, you know, ground sirloin, non-grass-fed options here, but they have so many different varieties that you can pick from. I spotted this Kevin's Keto Cauliflower Cheddar Soup. And you know, if it says keto, I gotta suss out the situation here. Again, it's keto certified, but we all know that that means absolutely nothing. So I went and checked in the ingredients list, and the ingredients list is pretty clean, except we have coconut sugar, and that is not ideal, and rice starch. So ideally, I feel like you could make this at home a little bit cleaner, a little bit better macros. If you're somebody, again, who's looking for an option because you don't have a lot of time and you don't cook, then maybe it's fine. But again, I feel like this is a really easy thing to make on your own for better macros. These egg bites, though, are phenomenal. And if you're somebody who's addicted to the ones from Starbucks, just like me, these are a pretty decent replacement. They're not as good as the one from Starbucks, I'm not gonna lie, but the carb count is a lot better. It's about 9 grams of carbs for two for the ones at Starbucks, and these are only 2 grams of carbs for the whole container, so it's a non-starter in terms of the health and the macro ratios on these, and you're definitely gonna save money doing it this way. This organic white meat chicken salad is also great for people who are looking for little snacks and stuff on the go, things to give to your kids if you're looking for them to be healthier, and also just to bring with you to the movies or something that's pre-packaged that you don't have to worry about. The ingredients on this are pretty good, and the macro ratios are amazing, absolutely idyllic, and most of the ingredients, I would say, are pretty great. Don't go for the ones that have cranberries or are sweet. That's gonna be much higher carb count. They also have my Siete brand chips. If you're going to eat a real chip, I love these. They're made with cassava flour, so they're not the lowest carb thing around, but the ingredients are super clean. These are a great option to bring with you if you're going to like a Mexican restaurant or you're doing Mexican takeout. Like I said, it's 16 net carbs per serving, which is about 16 chips, which isn't a ton, but I just love how clean the ingredients is. It's a family-run business. I really enjoy supporting Siete. They're awesome. And I just think these are good to have on hand if you can trust yourself to only eat 16 and they fit in your carb count. These I thought were going to be another flash in the pan horrible product because I was like, how could it be keto and paleo? You know, it just seemed a little fishy marketing. But then when I looked at the ingredients list, it was actually pretty clean. They give you different instructions on how to prepare to make it keto versus paleo. And the ingredients are all things that I would pretty much use at home, save for the chicory root fiber if I was making it at home. So I picked these up. I was actually pleasantly surprised. The problem is when it comes to tracking, it says it's by one brownie, but how big is a brownie, right? You have to weigh it. It's really a small brownie, you guys. 41 grams when it's made is really small. I tried tracking this at home. It was crazy. And honestly, I didn't feel like the taste was worth the price, but for a lot of people, they'll sacrifice a little bit of an amazing taste for the convenience of having it all already pre-mixed for you. But you still have to add the eggs and stuff. So for me, it's kind of like, okay, really, that's going to be a matter of personal preference. I also know these nut pods are really popular. I haven't tried them myself, but people rave about them. They're almond and coconut unsweetened. 10 bucks for three is probably a pretty decent deal, especially because these are really big bottles in general, even bigger than they are at the store. And the ingredients are really clean. It's not something that I feel like I need to add into my life, but if you like them, you can find them at Costco for a much better price. Oh man, one of the most famous things that Costco has is their $5 rotisserie chicken. They have admitted that they lose money on these chickens. These things are hefty, hefty, huge, and amazing, but they just bank that you're gonna spend more money in the store and that the rotisserie chicken will get you in there. They also have this whitefish salad. I know certain people are super into whitefish salad, and the macros on this are absolutely incredible, let alone all of the fish benefits that you're gonna get from this product. Again, this is a love it or hate it kind of thing, but a great option to get at Costco. They also have various different types of smoked salmon. Just make sure it's not sugar cured if you can help it. My family is obsessed with these folios. They're $8, but it's a bigger, thicker package than the one you would buy in the grocery store that only has about four. This one has about 10 per packet. They also have, Kerrygold cheese. The price, you guys, for all of these cheeses is per pound usually. It's not the actual block, so be careful there. They also have these great little snacks to keep on hand, these like meat-wrapped cheese. You might want to be careful that you don't overdo it on the dairy, y'all, because cheese can be highly addicting for some people, but this is also just great to have or bring to a party. The other thing that really blew my mind was this meat and cheese tray. So often with these trays, they have like a whole section that's just like the crackers, and this is literally just meat and cheese. Hello, thank you so much. I also saw right next to the folios these egg wraps. They're zero carb little egg wraps. My family loves using these. You can also use these to make like a keto lasagna. I have a client who does that, and they are also at a better price for a bulk item at $9 for this really large packet. It has 30 wraps. Can you hear the Alleluia chorus? All of this pork belly is crazy town. The meat at Costco is such amazing quality. It's not always the cheapest, but you get what you pay for. That's the theme of today's work, right? But this pork belly is amazing. And this is also a great place to take me up on my self-butchering videos I have on TikTok and Instagram. Buy the whole roast and butcher it yourself. It's so much cheaper. These steaks are the exact same steaks, but they are $3 more a pound because they've already been sliced for you versus the other one. I think that was $8.99 a pound and these are $11.99 a pound. So save what you can, y'all. Costco is one of the only places I've ever seen rib cap steaks like this. It's literally the best part of the ribeye, the cap, and they just wrap it around itself and turn it into its own steak. I don't ever see it anywhere else but Costco, so if you really want to indulge, go that route. Also, you really need to look at the marbling of each cut. Look at this one compared to the rest. This looks like Wagyu A5 marbling on a very inexpensive flap meat steak. I've been eating this all week. Oh my God, it is so amazing. So just don't necessarily look at the type, but look at the marbling. Costco also had some great bike options, y'all. If you haven't watched my Peloton hack video, go head over there right now. They had three different types of bikes at Costco. This one was 416, this one was 1,000, but it has a very smart system just like the Peloton, so it's definitely gonna be a higher quality option. This one is more similar to what I have, but it has magnetic resistance, which my bike does not, so that's why it's slightly more expensive. And then you have something like this that looks very similar to my bike, but is only 300 and some change. So if you are not wanting to wait to have a bike delivered and you wanna just go pick something up today, that's a great option.
Hopefully you guys found this helpful. Make sure that you have liked and subscribed to my channel. If you liked this video, let me know down below where I should go next, and I'll see you next time. Bye.